All right, good morning, good morning, good morning. Can you guys hear me? Audio check. All right, thank you, Abe. Good morning, Abe. Good morning, Adam. James, good morning, James. How are you? Jim, Khaled, Pat, Safe, Stephen, good morning. All right, guys, so let's get the show on the road. We have a 200 NT wrinkle that is positive along with 100. The market is in sync. We're looking for pullbacks as a buying opportunity against that 70, 60, 45, 35 harmony zone number one and two. We'll see how well they handle the pullback. We'll go from there. ES holding up, trading above Globex. Globex, actually in relation to NQ, ES is a little bit weaker, right? We have harmony zone number one, 40 by 37, 34 by 31, and Globex is 43, 46 and a half. Targets are 52.75. Targets for NQ is 120. Multiple captain setups going on here in NQ, in ES. Okay. A switch trade right here. Let's see if that holds up or not. It's early in the morning. It's only 3 minutes into the cash market open. I'm spending some time looking at this market. We have the 120 as a target to some of these rotations. Here we go. They're putting the captain setup short. And you look where we at. We are at the Globex, top end of the Globex band. So you're getting a market that's going to spend some time here. Yeah. See, they're responding to this captain setup on ES. Captain set up short on the 50 and the 50 and the 70. So I need to actually look into this as a shorting opportunity. Plus, you got a captain set up short on the 20 NT Rinko, and it's a captain set up switch trade. So there is a definitely a possibility of us seeing a retracement, a significant retracement here. Like I need to find a way to get in here. Oh, come on. Order submitted. Order filled. Okay, let's see if I can get some more. Well, I mean, let them push it up. I wouldn't mind them pushing it up a little bit. Okay, so this is the first test of Harmony Zone number one. I'm going to take the profit here, then I'm going to look to reload on the way back up. I mean, we're at the bottom end of the, well, here you go. That's okay. There's just too many distribution patterns coming across on both NQ and ES for this move not to be a significant one. I mean, we end up hitting target number two. We're trading under Harmony Zone number one, and they're heading all the way down to Globex. Like, look at that. Wow. Yeah. I knew I needed more contracts on this one, but I was hoping to get a bit of a bounce. Yep, Steven. I mean, that's that added to me getting in. I was like, you know, I needed to get in there quick too. Well, perfect for all of us. I don't know if anybody else jumped in on this deal or not, but Yeah, we had just too many things going on here not to participate. So now if we break into harmony zone number two, you're gonna get a complete 200 NT wrinkle reversal. And then we're gonna start looking at shorts in a more serious way. Meaning more contracts and staying in for bigger targets. Now we're right at Globex, and in and around this area you're gonna get a little bit of back and fill and consolidation. There you go. We're about to hit that target. That's very weak behavior. I mean, it's across the board. The only thing is just we came so close to that 20, 120, and just kind of bounced back. We got to tag that price level and hit it and close. Okay, watch out for this because if they put a captain setup, which they just did, that's going to flush the market a little bit because that's just similar to what they did here, up here. Okay, so we're just going to watch it. The only issue is we're right at Globex, and that's going to be a little bit noisy. Wow, I mean, how close are we getting to this thing and not hitting it? I mean, they're really trying to consolidate in this range the way they're doing it. All right, guys, so let's see what we're doing right here. So you have the market got back in sync, but they, you know, there's it's a weak price structure, and you could see them coming in hot and heavy on the short side. So we're gonna try to see if we can find ourselves an actual entry point short. I'm just gonna take one right here. Took one contract off, and I need to see a price under 43 in very quickly, or otherwise I'm gonna just punt this thing. Okay. Okay, I'm flattening this trade. Let's just let them get under 43, and actually they really need to get under 35. Well, there you go. Almost 9 o'clock, almost the top of the hour. We have existing home sales coming up soon. Natural gas at 9:30. Fed Chair Powell speaks, but that's at 11 o'clock Central Time, 12 o'clock Eastern. So that's going to be a bit of a time before that happens. Nine o'clock. Here we go. Yeah, that's most likely what's going to happen, Adam. Okay. They're gonna play this game again. I mean, I'll try one contract if they put a switch trade right here. Oh, come on. They're not gonna give it to me, are they? I'm not sure. There you go. They're gonna dance. They're gonna dance. Let them dance. I mean, if they put on 37 close, that would be a switch trade, two switch trades in a row, and those have been working very well. Okay, so we're not doing that number. Interesting. That's one contract off. I'd like to see a flush, man. I mean, 35 to 30. I should be able to get that. Yeah, we're just doing the dance around Globex, though. Ooh, that's not good. My stop has to be smaller now at 8. So I'll take a 10-point stop if this punches back up. It looks like it's going to do it. Yeah, I had to take that stop. It's just okay. So what are we doing here? We're really, you know, they're getting chewed in a very tight range between harmony zone number one, harmony zone number two. Okay, so I gotta leave this zone all alone. That's what I gotta do. Now if they run up back to the 65.75 and pull back, that would be viable, but right now we're going to have to see what they want to do, because they can't be just tagging up the top end of this range and the bottom end of this range and just kind of oscillate. Like, I don't necessarily want to be playing that game right here. I mean, in this range, we put, what is that? Two trades. And that's enough. Like one stop, one break even. So they need to either break above 70s and or the 30s and start, you know, pushing away from Globex. Yeah, they're holding it up. That's fine. I mean, that's what I was hoping to see, that 70 show up again with a pullback, though. I mean, they just did not pull it back. All right, so I mean that's significant in the fact that this is the spot where the market kind of needed to close the 33, and that would have put a market out of sync, and then, you know, potentially that reversal. I mean, they got all the way down to that level and just boom, rallied it back up. That's just amazing to me. Adam, you're fat fingers over there. Hey Chima, how are you, buddy? Yeah, I mean, here we go again. I mean, this is the type of market we're dealing with here. They hit the top end of the Globex band and they're pulling back, testing Harmony Zone number one. Ride the wave, baby, ride the wave, yes, sir. All right. Okay, so we're seeing. Okay, so here we go again with another push. So we're back to the zone of consolidation, like literally back to it, from it to it, and it just back and forth. That's just a consolidated market, which is okay. We're just gonna have to spend a little bit more time with it and see if we can get a break to that 33 and a close. That will set the stage for something a little bit solid. All right. So now we're at the bottom end of that and that range. So we're moving from the top end of the Globex band to the bottom end of the Globex band. We have a harmony zone number one that shifted to 45 by 55, and 70 by 80 is harmony zone number two. And we'll see if we can get up there to that level.
Order submitted. Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order canceled. Order canceled. Order filled.
All right, I mean we took that test. It's not a bad trade at all. I mean, we took two, it took a little bit of profit, then I added to it and took more right here. It has a lot more potential, to be honest with you, but you know, we're just going to take our profits in these tests and see if I can get into another rotation lower. I didn't even get a one tick of loss, or like one tick of heat on that thing. All right, guys, so we are at 442 for the day. Let's see if we can build on that. So to get, I mean, okay, so the 200 and the 100 now are out of sync. See what I'm saying? Like, you know, you see the 100 is just positive, the 200 is negative, and they're testing harmony zone number one for the first time. You're getting that type of behavior right now, okay? So what do I need to do with it? I need to see a break below 20 right now. I need to see a push. And the cloud shifting negative. And then we'll start looking for that target. And that target came very close at 15,000. And that 15,000 is a psychological number too. Okay, so there's a lot more going on here than just, you know, the price action. You got that psychological number at 15,000. The market is going to spend some time trying to digest this and build up stops. And it's going to consolidate here for a little bit. So I need to kind of be more on a scalping mode than to short and to hold for a bigger target. You know, the target is 95, and after that target, we have target number two on the 200 in Tiurinko, which will be 949, a significant. And then that's just the bottom of that move, and you're going to get a little bit of a push. You're going to start picking up a lot more momentum if that happens. It's 9:42. Okay. So that's a third test of harmony zone number one. I definitely don't want to be like trying to short here. Why? Because this is going to be a noise area, and they can like pump it up to 60s and then reverse. We need to see a little bit more price action here, especially around Globex. Okay, like you almost have to see 15,021 or 70 in order for us to start getting a bit better idea about how the price is gonna, who's the dominant force in this area. Across the board, from Abe to Steven, how are we doing, by the way? Adam, how are we doing? Jim, any trades? Khaled, any trades? Pat, Chima, Sheila. Captain set up short. Okay, well that's a good thing to see. That's a good thing to see. You see this? Captain set up short right on Globex. All right, so I'm going to go one to two contracts and see how well we can start looking for Khaled down a little bit, small green for Pat. Adam 2600. Up on both eval accounts 500. Go with your bad self, Chima. Go with your bad self. And Steven, what are you doing over there? 860? Good for you. I like it. Here we go. Here we go. That's good to see. That's good to see. That's the first reaction. So we're seeing, look what we're seeing here. We're seeing this captain set up and this punch and this punch, both of them are lower highs and the cloud is shifting. So that's a positive thing to see on. On the short side. I mean, if they close this thing at 25, that'll be a switch trade and I'll take a short. That's gonna suck, but let's see here if I can still hold on to it. Nope. Like they really have to kind of come in there and close. Okay. Yeah, that's gonna suck. All right, that's fine. Gonna get out of that trade. It just, whenever you get into anywhere around Globex, you're gonna get price action that's just gonna sit here and does this noise back and forth, no direction. That's okay, that's okay. Let's just keep working. Let's keep working. I mean, we have the right ideas, right? But we're just getting... That was getting caught in a little bit of a noise area. Shorts are definitely dominant. You got the 200 and the 100 out of sync, but if we get to 06, then that will get back in sync. And I'm going to be looking for these rallies as a shorting opportunity. Well, we're going to be still looking for those shorts. It just, you're getting a disconnect and a retest of that bottom. We needed to close at 06 in order for us to really kind of start moving with momentum. So I'm waiting for the market to at least get to 15, and on a rally after getting to 15, I'll take a shot at it. Okay, see that? All right, so here we go. Come on, don't do this.
Order submitted.
Let's see if I can get those two things order going submitted. Here. Yeah, we needed that fill right there. I'm gonna take a stop right here. They put a captain setup, so you know, just I'll take a small stop on one contract and I'll just wait. Okay. Now let's do it again here.
Order submitted. Order submitted.
All right, the 200 and the 100 are back in sync, and we are looking for an entry point short.
Order submitted. Order canceled. Order filled.
Okay, I took one out just because the way this price is moving. I just have one left and see if I can get something going here. That's my stop right here. Here we go. Come on. I know I shouldn't be getting greedy, but trying to protect that 15,000, which is a reasonable place for me to take a profit anyway. But you know, I was hoping to see a little bit of a push lower. So we made money on the first one and the second one, which is a good thing. So they're just protecting 15,000. I mean, I know they're going to do that, but that's okay. I mean, they're just liking the shorts. I mean, that's just basically the bottom line here. Target is 995. Let's take a look at ES and talk about ES for a little bit here. Kind of same consolidated with a short pattern that we're seeing. We have, absolutely. You have a complete 50 inch wrinkle reversal. You have harmony zone number one, which is 34 by 37 and 40 by 43. Rallies are shortable. We'll reevaluate if we break 43.40 and looking for a target of 21.5. We break that level, we're going to go to 14.75, then 81.50. That's 42.81.50. That's a big deal here. So if we stick this short into this next target of 21, then things will start rolling into that direction. I think what you're going to probably see from a geopolitical thing, I think the market is going to be responding to a potential, expansion of the war in the Middle East, and they're going to start worrying about the impact of that on oil, and then the potential of stuff getting worse. So that is going to put a lid on the market. We're going to start seeing a little bit of more dominance of the shorts. So 13. Yeah. You could see, I mean, the way they're trading it, though, the way they're trading this is just such a spiky, and they're not respecting too much of the middle of the range. Like, there's two spots where they reacted to the middle of the range. That's just one of them here where I got involved, and the second one is at 10:10 right now, and they're not really truly respecting it, and they're reversing it. So what is that telling me? That's telling me just the nature of the market today is you have to trade at the edges of price action above the cloud, and not necessarily at the middle of the range. And be willing to, if you want to get into the middle of the range, that you are gonna add to it at these levels. Tesla tanking, okay. I mean, here you go. All right, so we hit that target actually. So now we got a new set of targets here. 970 is the next target. And harmony zone number one is 20 by 30 and 45 by 55. Harmony zone number two. And we're looking for these rallies to short into. And we're, this is another key. We're expanding away from expanding away from the Globex band. That generates momentum. Damn. We know it. 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 All right. So next target's 945. Zone number one is 995 by 15,005 and 20 by 30 is harmony zone number two. And we're looking for rallies to short into. We'll reevaluate anything above 15,010. Yeah, I mean it's gonna keep going, guys. 45 is the target on this deal here. This is the target. Thank you. All right, we're testing Harmony Zone number one for the first time. Against that whole number. I'm expecting them to really challenge that.
Order filled. Target filled.
I'll take it. Let's try to see this again. Yeah. Put it on the wrong account. Let's say, I mean, they're gonna play around with it for a little bit here. I mean, you go anything above 09, we're gonna get ourselves into consolidation. You know, that first attempt at Harmony Zone number one is typically your best shot, but let's see. ES is continuing to show pressure. Oh my God. they're really challenging the shorts right here. Like, that's just a very meaningful challenge to it. I mean, we had that one rotation here. Now this attempt at harmony zone number 2 came in very close to the bottom end of that range and tested once and twice, and now they're breaking. And that's just overall a pattern of this long pattern. I mean, if they break 45, then we have to kind of consider pullbacks as buyable and start looking in that direction. That's interesting. It's brainwashing 101. Brainwashing 101. So I mean, look at what they did here. I mean, that just a very tricky little deal that they got going on here. A captain set up short 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, and they flipped it. I mean, and that's not a bad spot here for anybody to just kind of go short as a fade against that move, and they ran it over. I mean, if they flip this candle down to 32.25. I mean, that the market can stabilize and start pushing lower. But if we go back up to Globex, which is 45, then that closes the 200 NT wrinkle. And that happened. Pullbacks are viable. You got what you got. Next target in this rotation is 15,070. ES is struggling with this short as well. Testing harmony zone number 2. And a reversal pattern will start at 43.46.5. And that would be a switch trade long on ES on the 50 NT Renko. So you're getting counter trend behavior here. Because the overall trend is short. I mean, it's just quite obvious right here. Yeah. That's the trend. But that doesn't mean within that trend you're not going to get counter trends. Because look at this one. Look at this one. And look at where, we had that behavior back up to the middle of the range. So you're getting a stair step behavior where the market short up, short up, short up. Now the key to this right here is this candle closing lower. That'll be a switch trade, then you're gonna get that move lower. If we break anything above this level, which is 15,116, that kind of changes the equation for this rotation. We will start getting a retest of that descending channel. Okay, so the next couple of candles are critical from a swing trade perspective. If they stick this rotation and actually close this candle lower, even if they come up to this level, then reverse, that's still good. Then you have that target of 949.75. Then you got the target of 828 as a possibility. All right, guys, so that's where we at so far for today. Yeah, we're just up $200. I mean, we tried a couple of times. We got a couple of stops along the way, and we ended up basically where we at right now. So it's a positive day. I'll take it. The day's not over either. That's where we at for the month so far. 596. That's where we at. So they're pulling back a little bit right here. Yeah, that's gonna be something. He's talking. You could tell he's talking. Boom. Yeah, that's something. Okay, so the next target got hit. So they flushed it just to really rip everybody up on that one. That's how you go. Boom. Next target, 145. They're putting a captain setup short right here. So we're going to, you know, take a look. Yeah, it's just, where is that thing? You got a switch trade here, switch trade. I mean, there's a lot of good stuff here. It's just a fast market. We'll take a quick look at it here. See if there's anything I can do with this market. They're most likely going to, here we go, testing harmony zone number one. Watch them come all the way down to Globex. Just watch it, which will be really sick for them to do that. But they, you know, that would be a thing the market would do. $14,700. Wow, that's a little bit. Now the market is out of sync. We hit the top end of the Globex band, and you know we're getting faded here a little bit. Woo, baby. See? I'm just telling you. It's not like I haven't seen this, you know, this song and dance before. Bastards. I mean, you know, imagine all these people that got caught up here and not realized that the market was shifting. They just getting smoked. Yeah, we're going to hit Globex. Just watch. All right, guys, so it's, what is it? It's 11 o'clock, 11:07. Some action going on, some momentum, some back and forth. I'm going to take a break. It's 11 o'clock, 11:07. I'll take a break and come back a little bit later on and see if there's any trades that worth taking. Okay, so a good day trading, another positive day. And just keep on doing what's working, and whatever we're doing is working. Okay, so we'll see you guys bright and early Friday, and we'll round up the week on a good note and enjoy the weekend. Okay, so we'll see you for today, and remember, right? Precision is a decision, and always trade in harmony. Okay, guys, take care.
canceled.
Fuck. All right, so let's just take a break. If you look at it, it's over. It's over, baby. It's over. You took a Well.
Order submit, order filled. Order sub order filled.
Yeah, that's good enough. That's good enough. Yeah, that's going to be... $12.77. I think that's good enough. Yeah, we'll call it a day right here. We're gonna see a lot of potential on the downside anyway, but you know, that's good to see. Yeah, we're gonna see a lot of that push. You have Harmony Zone number one, Harmony Zone number two. You got all that resistance to any upward momentum. It's getting... We're getting cleaner. Cleaner moves now. All right. We'll call it a day. 1270. That's a good day. We'll call it.